Guys doing a couple people here. What I have today is heavy, but I have this laptop case, and I know I already ruined it. Let's see what's in here. Oh, the first one. I'll start it off cool. This is from Anaheim, Mighty Ducks Digest. No Cinderella story. That's Peter Sikora here, as you can see. Scotty Stevens here. This is from when I went to Anaheim in November of 2003. After the Devils beat Anaheim in the Stanley Cup, which we will, you know, we'll get to those as well. So I'm going to go over some Center Ice magazines. I'm going to give away a couple of these in the next month, whether it be right now or at the Stadium Series game. I'll have a couple of these. Some of them have autographs in them. Some of them have really cool stuff. So I don't want to just give it away to anyone. These will be given away to people who see me at the Stadium Series. And you'll see why. These are very special to me. I've kept them hidden in a laptop case for a reason. Gino, if anyone's asking, is at the window over there, but if you see, there's way too much light from the window where Gino likes to plop himself and look outside, so I had to... I'm not even using my webcam, I'm just using the usual piece of shit camera for my laptop, this laptop. As I watch, you guys can chat. If anyone's watching and wants to chat, I have the chat open right here on the side. On a different laptop, so I know I just had a few viewers. A couple of guys are gone. A lot of these videos people watch later on. Okay, so anyway, 2003-2004 official game magazine of the New Jersey Devils. This one is from the commemorative Stanley Cup banner raising celebration. So this is from opening day, in the 2003-2004 season, when the Devils put the banner up for their 2003 cup. Of course, you have the whole team involved in the magazine. These magazines are in mint condition. Well, I would say maybe a 9 out of 10 for most of them. One or two of them, maybe an 8. Look, I love this stuff. Look, NJ Devils been around for so long. Official signals. They really need to figure these out these days. NJ Devil knew them. And he knew when to call him too. The officials these days don't. I haven't worn this jersey. As you can see, this jersey's signed by the whole team from this year, this season. This is this season's team. So this one has Toffoli, you know, all the newer players on the team. No sex on here. Anyway, let's see what else is cool inside this one. Now, this one, of course, they all have, they played the Maple Leafs, so they would have the rosters for the game already printed. So they would print these basically the day of the game. In most cases, later on. Earlier on, they would come like this, and there'd be a sheet of paper with the rosters in it, which you're going to see from older ones that might have them in here. Also, please let me know in a comment or anything. Check this out. If you want me to read this book live, I was thinking about reading this book live. 25, this is the 25th anniversary book, 25, The History of the Devils in New Jersey. It's one of my favorite seasons. I have two 25th anniversary jerseys. There's a Jansen one there, and I have a Zajac one. Zajac, who I believe is going to be the next Ring of Honor inductee as a player. If they do the next player they do, I believe it should be and will be Travis Zajac. If not, you got Bruce Driver. But I think Travis Zajac put a little more in, even though Driver had, you know, he came out with that Captain C on at the Breland ceremony. Which reminds me, if you read my article or if you didn't, please check my article out. What I'm actually going to do is, right now I'm going to pull my article up and I'm going to show you a little something. Anyone who, I guess maybe I'm not going to do that. It's almost like every time I decide to go live, I'm not hardwired, so, you know, I'm going through Wi-Fi. Every time I go live, it seems the Wi-Fi wants to shit out. So here's another one with Scott Stevens on the cover. This is 2002-2003, Devils vs. Montreal, Tuesday, January 7th, 2003. So this is from the season that they won the Cup. Obviously, beforehand, we're going to get into other ones from the playoffs and from the finals of that year. Renewed enthusiasm about Brodeur. There's a nice, really great written articles. Things were done really well back then. As you can see here, Sarge, Sergei Breland. Now, this one is in mint condition for, well, this one's a 9.5. Yeah, these Center Ice magazines, you know, a lot of people just, you know, would get them, bring them home. Oleg Tverdovsky. Bring them home and just toss them somewhere. I never did. I always put them away. Pat Burns doing what he does best. Rest in peace, Pat Burns. Now, Pat Burns is another Ring of Honor. Hey, what's up, Kevin Ball enthusiast? I think Pat Burns and Travis Zajac are the two Ring of Honor people that are next. Zajac being the next player that should get it. Pat Burns as a coach. Passed away, rest in peace, Pat Burns. Should also be in the Devil's Ring of Honor. So as the years go on, we'll see if I got that right, because I did call Sergei Breland. That was a good call. So now these used to come with this. You would have a Devil's scorecard. You'd have your own scorecard if you wanted to sit in the stands, because people didn't have iPhones when this magazine came out. This is 2002, 2003. Well, this is January 7th, 2003. People didn't have iPhones and whatever other phones you guys use. Of course, we got the Devil's lineup printed inside the Center Ice magazine. Obviously, it doesn't show who's scratched or not for the game because they printed it a little earlier than, you know, printed it probably like the day before. Tommy Albeline lends a helping hand by Phil Covey. A little article on Tommy Albeline in this one. Great. Thank you so much, man. I don't know what to call you. I'll just call you the Ball Goat. How about that? Oh, you are Kevin Ball Goat. Because isn't your other thing Kevin Ball enthusiast? I'm watching my chat on a different computer right here, if you're wondering. All right, so Ball Goat, which sounds kind of funny, like in a sexual way, like he's the Ball Goat. like, you know, like back in high school, you would call one of the girls that is known for being a little promiscuous the Ball Goat. You know what I'm saying? Well, I don't know how old you are, but I haven't been in high school in a long time, so. All right, so, oh, look, Pat Burns, a little thing on Pat Burns there. This says, this day in hockey. So this goes for January 7th, this day in hockey, and this is from 2003, December 4th, Scott Stevens became the 22nd player in NHL history to appear in 1,300 games when the Devils lost 4-2 to the visiting Flames. Okay, let's move on. First of all, this is obviously not a real ticket. This is a cool piece of memorabilia that I have. But here is the 2003 Stanley Cup Finals program. Beautiful program. New Jersey Devils versus the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim. 2003 Stanley Cup Finals. Yeah, you know, I wish the room that I have, this is the only place I have to do this stuff, and this is where all the hockey memorabilia is in my house. So, I really wish I could turn things around and not have the sun coming in from this side. And it sucks because at nighttime, then I have lighting problems too. You know, I don't have the best lighting situation where I'm recording stuff these days, but it is what it is. Now in here, we got Richard Schmalick, Scott Stevens, Colin White, and Ken Danico. Check that out. Let me make my thing bigger, and let me also put a different song on. All the background music is made by me for my own use, so I could put some little sound behind what I do. Just if anyone's wondering where the music comes from. Some people have this. Oh, they're doing it all. Look at this. Ray Giroux. Ray Giroux, underrated player. Loved Ray Giroux. Look at this one. Number eight. Steven Gwala. You tell me if you know who that is. You tell me if you know who that is, because I don't even know who it is. Now, I consider myself a historian of the Devils. Jeff Friesen. Jeff Friesen should also be not put into, you know, like the Devils Ring of Honor, but, you know, I think he should be, for what he did in the trade, he came in for, you know, Peter Sikora was sent out, and everyone's like, what, you know, why would they make a move to get rid of Sikora? You know, Eliash, Sikora, Arnott, it was a big thing. Well, it worked out. Jeff Friesen was the catalyst to get the Devils to the Stanley Cup, and also partially to win it too. I think he had two goals in Game 7, actually, or Mike Rupp had two goals and he had the other one. I'm not sure, but let's see what magazine I have next. Ooh, look at this one. Sunday, April 21st, 2002. Another Stevens. Is it the same exact picture? No, it's not. Eastern Conference Quarterfinals, Devils versus Hurricanes. Sunday, April 21st, 2002. I believe that's the day that Lane Staley from Alice in Chains was found dead. And they figured out he died a couple weeks earlier or 2 weeks earlier. But they announced it on the radio while we were on our way to this game, I think. Or it was definitely Devils versus Hurricanes playoffs that me, my brother, and my whole family were driving from New York to New Jersey for the game. And we heard that Lane Staley from Alice in Chains had died. I believe this was the date. I'm going to have to double check that. I can't be sure. I realize going through these magazines isn't as exciting as I thought it would be. So, let me show you some other ones. Eastern Conference Semifinals, May 2nd, 2003. Devils versus Lightning. That's my father's birthday. Second of all, do you know what game this is? Does anyone know what game this is? That's triple overtime Grant Marshall win game. This is from the game that Grant Marshall won in triple overtime. Now, this is what I was talking about earlier, where they give you the paper stapled, literally just stapled with player stats and the lineups for the night. So they add those in, you know, later on. And they make the Center Ice magazine, and then they add the roster when they get it. Devils versus Leafs, Thursday, October 12, 2006, 25th anniversary, Silver Season, my favorite year. This is another home opener one. Most of these are from home openers. Now remember, one of the reasons I'm showing this to you guys is to Brad Lukowich and Dan Locatore, two Devils, that long forgotten Devils. The reason I'm showing you guys these things is because I'm going to be giving them away. Holding on to all this stuff for so long is becoming a chore. It really is. I mean, I got things hanging on the wall behind me because I have nowhere else to put them. You know what I'm saying? Like, look at this. National Hockey League referees and linesmen back when they had some credibility. Remember that? Long, long ago. Long, long ago. That was in a better time. And also, that was when this wasn't Bud Light. Well, it always tasted Bud Light. Anyway, this one, Friday, October 10th, 2008. So obviously, again, a home opener against the Islanders. Which, you know, as someone who grew up next to the Nassau Coliseum, it sucks having, you know, I just went to the Devils-Islanders game November 28th in New Jersey, also October 20th here in Long Island, but Aquafina was the official water of the Devils at the time. But driving for a home opener game to see them play the Islanders sucks, you know? I don't know who won that game, I don't remember, but again, it's funny how they put the Devils in color, but the Islanders, they put in black and white, their logo. Is that like a little little shitting on them? Look at this. Come together. I like that. Come together, the picture. It's got Colin White there. You can see Gianta. I got to look forward. Johnny Madden and maybe Zach Parise? Is that Zach? Must be Zach Parise, yeah. Okay. Now, 25th anniversary. This is why. Did I freeze up? No. Okay, so the 25th anniversary. Let's check this stuff out, guys. Okay, I got all these things, and they all. Maybe this one doesn't. Oh, no, these. 25th anniversary in the corner. So check this out. He got the 2002-2003 Devils. So that's the Stanley Cup champion Devils. A couple of moves were made, so maybe that's not the full Stanley Cup champion team. You got the 91-92 Devils. Look at that. You got the 97-98 Devils. This is why this is the Devils joint. There's a lot of stuff here that no one's ever seen. 98-99 Devils. And this is all stuff that is going to be given away because I just can't hold on to all this stuff anymore. This one is the 2003-04 Devils. I don't know why. I guess this was a giveaway or something. This is different. This isn't from the 25th anniversary. Now, I also have, like, 25th anniversary calendars. I have a couple of these. Obviously, I believe each one commemorates different times in the Devils' history. For their 25 years at the time. Now we're in 41. They did play the Rangers at the Garden on February 22nd, 2007. Here is inaugural season at the Rock team calendar, 2007-2008. Sorry. Which I also have, and I'll be bringing the inaugural poster from opening night at the Prudential Center. I have a few of these. Of course, I have a bunch of this poster and the Raise Your Voice posters from last year's playoffs I have. I also have, I should have got them while I was up. All right, so these are what I give away most, and I'm gonna have a lot. I have a lot of these, as you can see, there's a stack of them right here. These are double-sided. One side is Marty Brodeur. It says Devils Hockey, live it, eat it, breathe it, did it. And on the other side, Scott Stevens. You want one of these? Let me know. Comment below. And also, These are from 2003 also. And I've been giving away a lot of these. I have about maybe 15 of them left. Bud Light congratulates. But on my wall over there says Bud Light. Devils. Oh, see, it says Stanley Cup champs, but it doesn't show the Devils logo on there, which I don't like. But either way, it's a piece of memorabilia. Now, there are other things that I have that are going to be coming with me. There'll be t-shirts, of course. Now, this is what I wanted to ask Captain Stevens, my friend. Is this the shirt that I'm supposed to send you? What size is that? Extra large? Is this Brodeur skated on shirt from the retirement ceremony? Is this shirt the one that I'm supposed to send to you? I don't want to put it up as a giveaway, and it was something I'm supposed to send to you because I know I owe you a shirt. So please let me know if you see this. I'm going to, obviously, I asked you in our private group chat. Anyone who wants to join Devils Anonymous, it's a Devils group chat that I started. There's about 22 of us in there at this point. It's just Devils chat, nothing crazy, you know, but it's, I came out of a Metro, well, I'm still in it, a Metro chat, but it's really mostly Rangers talk. There's no Flyers or Penguins talk. It's Islanders and Rangers and, you know, hardly any Devils, so I made my own Devils group chat. If you're interested in joining, remember you can mute notifications, so you can be in the group chat and it won't keep ringing when when people are actually talking, like later in the day when people get to chatting during the game and stuff. Your phone's not going to keep going off. You can mute the notifications. You don't have to leave the group. Some people left the group for that reason, and I understand that, but they didn't realize you could leave. You could just mute it. Anyway, like I said, if you check out, I'm going to put it back in my pinned comment, because as of now, this is in my pinned comment. If you check out my article, which was sabotaged by the publisher, about Sarge, who I'm going to make my background for some reason. That was an accident. Sorry. Let's put it up to power play. Power play. This. I don't know. Anyway, someone tell me what's the best look? The three jersey things. I don't know. But let's look at Sarge. Let's go through some. I didn't add Holtz yet to this because I made Holtz. But let's check out the Saints in Newark. We got Brat. We got Brat and Lazar. We got Dawes. Hughes. Luke. I haven't done a Jack one. Mikey Mack. Nemo. Cap, and of course, Timo. Have not gotten to Foley yet. Here's a picture of Max Willman rookie card that I have. I happen to open in one of my things. Oh, here's another poster. Here's a picture of it, because I have one on the wall and I don't have them available. I think I do, but I don't want to go get it. They're right over there. But these posters right here, I also have available. 2006, 2007 season, or 2008, 2000, I forgot what season this is from. Actually, I have to go look. Okay. 2005, 2006. I have a bunch of this poster. It's really cool. It's, you know, obviously before they raised all the banners, so they only have two up there. It's got a lot of players. Can't really show it too well on here, but hopefully the new setup when me and Tim start our Devil's show, which will not be called the Devil's Joint. I've been trying to get away from the name Devil's Joint for so long. It's actually ironic. Sorry. I am looking for something, because you know what I do have is a Devil's Joint. I don't know where I put it, and right now is the one of the best times to light it up. All right, so here, how about this? Let's go to some clips. Let's watch this goal here.
Sure against Bluger on the faceoff. And the Devils win it. Luke Hughes to Jack Hughes. Rashad tipped him for the save. Now, Luke Hughes scores. Puck bounced out to him and he just ripped it past Demko.
There is Lukey. I found my Devils joint. All right, so now watch this Nico Hischier. This is a short one, but watch Nico Hischier block this shot.
Rebound! Besser couldn't put it home. Pettersson, Kuzmenko, blocked by Hischier.
And what a great block it was. Yes, you just saw me pull a lighter right out of a package and use it for the first time. The rare things you see when you watch the Devil's Joint, guys. The unbelievable sights. Anyway, what I wanted to do... Well, let's pull this up. Let's do this. That was the Saints of Newark, but I'm going to have to redo that because obviously I've been adding more Saints of Newark photos. I hope you guys enjoy those. Not many people are leaving likes or anything on those photos, but I think they're cool. That's just me, though. All right, so I was going to do cards. That was what I said earlier, but instead I decided, you know what? First of all, the Timo Meier t-shirt giveaway is still going on, and that goes, it goes for every post that has one of my articles in it. So now there's a new post. It's about Sergei Breland's ceremony. It's about his history as a Devil, why they inducted him into the Ring of Honor. My publisher took out all my embedded tweets, so look in my highlight section for all the things that are missing, because it will unfortunately say, look at this video below, and then there's no video, that they took them out. So, there's a bunch of Karens that go tattletaling, and these are adult Karens, of course, tattletaling on each other. And not the best way to work. But either way, I forgot where I was going with that. I was gonna do cards. I have a lot of old hockey cards, 90s cards that are cool, that any hockey fan would love to see. I'll do that another time. I decided to do some Devils memorabilia, show you some stuff that I'm giving away. And if you see something you specifically want, you can DM me or message me in any way and offer, I'll give you $25 for this, you know, that bobblehead, or that's just rant. I'm not saying a bobblehead is $25. I'm just making up numbers here. So everything I show is available. A lot of it is given away for free, but you got to win it. And I always have a third party picking winners. It's never me picking them, except for once or twice I have to admit I have picked someone that I think deserved it. Not for any big giveaways, like the Luke Hughes hat giveaway went to someone up in upstate New York. A girl who is a big Luke Hughes fan. Believe she has she's like autistic, and she wrote me a very heartfelt letter, and I picked her specifically for that, you know. And I'm not gonna lie, I appreciate everyone, you know, reposting my stuff and everything. I always do giveaways for the right reason. I want to get the stuff out to fans because I have all of it. I have all this stuff, and there's fans out there that don't have anything. I have my friend down in Texas. I sent, you know, he helped me out big time. He helped me get this microphone sent when I needed it the most. He helped me get this thing here ASAP. I sent him a box full of stuff. Actually, some of the stuff I actually realized wasn't in the box because I found it later on, like months later, in the back corner of this room, and I felt bad, but I sent him a bunch of stuff. You got the Devil's Marvel comic books, Devils of Destiny. I have those. Those will also be with me at Stadium Series. If you want one, let me know. I'll give it away. I have a few that I have to send out still. I have hats. Devils hats autographed. I have a red Devils hat that's autographed by three players. If you can guess the three players, you can have the hat. That's gonna be that. I'm gonna go live and do that. So, you know, I have a lot of things that I wanna do. Hopefully me and Mr. Tim Wood at Tim W-U-U-D. Go give him a follow. We are gonna get a little Devils show going. It's not so much a podcast, but just a show where we can talk Devils, have our friends and followers on with us to chat. You know, I've had a few Devils fans that follow me come on live before I stream the games and stuff. I'd love if any of you guys ever want to come on and talk Devils before the game starts. I'll start the stream a half hour early. We could show clips. We can do this. We can do that. Also, what I wanted to do was I have the whole Sergei Brelin Ring of Honor ceremony here in this computer. So I'm going to see if I can upload that into here and play it. Let's see. This is why I need new lighters all the time. I just opened it and then I lost it. You know why? Because I put it back in the fucking package. Alright, I want to see, it's freezing me up. Okay, so go to downloads, Brelin Ring of Honor. Let's see if it'll, because you know, it's a long video. It's not that long, it's 13 minutes or something. But yeah, it's freezing up my computer now. So if this stream ends, it's because of that. I'm not gonna bother with that. Let me try and X out of there. I would like to show, all right, see, it froze me up. And you know what? I don't even throw up my, like, once or twice during a stream, I throw up my, like, Cash App thing. You know, I'm having surgery on Wednesday. You know, this is what I do. This is my work. This is the only way I make money right now is through the Devil's content that I provide and write. So for me to not put out like some sort of donation thing is crazy. But I feel like I feel like a grifter doing that. But I'm struggling, and it's necessary. You know, and I do get a lot of views sometimes where it would be helpful. But I don't know. Anyone who hears this, let me know what you think. Should I put my Cash App thing up in my like ticker below when I do streams and stuff, just to see, you know, maybe helps people can help, because I pay for this program to stream. I pay for VPNs, all that stuff to make that happen. It's not free, so I can see I'm lagging and stuff now. So I'm just gonna end this broadcast. I will see you guys later. Thanks for watching. I'll end it on a good note. I can't even end it on a good note because everything's frozen. I don't even think I can end it. Well, let's see how long it takes to end. We'll smoke this in the meantime.